Hi friends, hope you're doing good. Welcome. So how many of you like physics? Frankly speaking, I'm liking and appreciating physics more nowadays as compared to my school days. Why am I asking you this? That's because in today's video, we will talk about the physics of jump rope, especially the forces which are at play when we jump rope. The main forces at play are the centripetal force, centrifugal force, and of course, gravity. Once we understand these forces, we will appreciate jumping rope more, and especially weighted jump ropes or heavy jump ropes. Before we get into the video, let me show you something. This is a concept I saw on YouTube where a teacher uses this setup to explain the concept of centripetal force and centrifugal force. So what do we have here? We have a heavy object here. We have a very light object here, tied with a string, and the string goes through a plastic pipe. And the question the teacher poses to the class is, how can you make this light object lift the heavy object with one condition, without touching either of these objects? So the students come and try different things, like giving this setup a big shake. So yes, the heavy object goes up, but it doesn't stay there, it comes down because of gravity. So how do we get the light object to pull the heavy object without touching either of the object? Very simple, start spinning the lighter object. I hope you can see it. Once I start spinning, the heavy object came up. We will do it once more. Give the small object a spin. See, the heavy object starts going up. This magic or the miracle is because of physics and the two forces which come into play when you spin an object, like a jump rope also. These two forces are the centripetal force and the centrifugal force. One force is towards the direction of the center of spin, and the other force is away from the center of the spin. So even if we do it on a horizontal plane, you can see that the lighter object is able to pull a weight which is significantly higher than its own weight because of the forces which are at play. So this is the concept with jump ropes, especially heavy jump ropes also. While using a heavy jump rope, a few of which I have in my hand, this is the 500 grams boxer Muay Thai heavy jump rope, and these are heavier ropes from cross rope. In fact, I have ropes which are heavier than these also. But for the purpose of this video, for the purpose of demonstration, I'll use this 500 gram PVC rope because the noise levels are a bit more acceptable. If I go with a heavier rope, my neighbor who lives below my flat will come and complain. The concept we just saw with that spinning object is applicable to jump ropes also. So in this case, the center of the circle is the wrist, the handle, which we are holding. And the circle is the path of the jump rope which goes around us. When we are using a heavy jump rope like this or any other heavy jump rope, it is not only a cardio workout, but it is also a resistance training workout. Why do I say it's a resistance training workout? I'll explain it to you. You would have noticed when you use a heavy jump rope and you're jumping at a decent speed, the rope has a tendency to pull you in the direction it is spinning, which is away from the center. So unless and until you are engaging your muscle groups, be it core, glutes, chest, shoulder, arms, wrist, the rope will just pull you the way it wants to go. By engaging these muscle sets, what is the body doing? The body is trying to resist or balance the centripetal force. Now the second point, when you're using a heavy jump rope and jumping at a decent speed, you would notice that you'll be holding the handles really tight, most probably in a power grip. Your arms are consciously close to your body and you'll be locking your armpits. You'll be maintaining a tight form. That's because when you're jumping with a heavy rope, you'll feel the constant push of the rope towards the center of the circle, that is the wrist or the handle. So this tight form that you maintain by engaging these muscle groups is the way the body is balancing or resisting the centrifugal force. In summary, to counter all these forces, centripetal force, centrifugal force, and gravity, you will maintain a tight form throughout your jump. Any slackness, the heavy rope is very unforgiving. Either you will get hurt or the rope will make you lose your rhythm. So friends, this was a layman's take on the physics behind the jump rope and the advantages of using a heavy jump rope, which is basically higher muscle engagement, better form, and a form of resistance training, not just cardio, with heavy jump ropes. You can go a step further by actually calculating these forces by using the radius of the rope, which is typically half the length of the rope. The speed of the rope, you can arrive by the jumps per minute into the circumference of the circle the rope is doing around you, which is 2 pi r, pi, you know, constant, 22 by 7. And then you need the mass of the rope, which is basically, you know, the weight divided by gravity, 9.8. I won't get into that in today's video. I don't think I'll get into that at all. But in case you like the video, do leave it in the comment section. Question or feedback, please do feel free to leave it in the comment section. And in case any viewers are physics experts and you found something wrong in this video, I welcome you to come and correct me in the comments section. My request is keep the explanation simple, no formulas please, so that one, I can understand your explanation, and anybody else who comes to the comment section can also understand the explanation or the correction. That's it friends for today's video. I hope you liked it. I hope to see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.